Hey everybody, we're back in Farming Simulator 2013 Platinum Edition, and we are at the new field, starting a new game, and I already forgot the name of the new town, but that doesn't matter. The last video, I did a little introductory to the game. And we're gonna hop in guns blazing. We're gonna go right into debt. And apparently you start out $94,000 in debt. First thing we're gonna do is see. I didn't check out the new placeable objects. That's something I didn't. The same as last. And yes, I will be playing this game with mods because I like mods. But first things first, we're gonna get us a nice little sprayer. Well, spreader. And also going to I'm gonna upgrade our wagon. So we're gonna sell this junk one we got. Get a little more in debt. There we go. And gonna get our just go ahead and set our new equipment over here. This is a little trick I learned in the old Farming Simulator 2012. Go ahead and hook this wagon up to this tractor. Hopefully this whole thing will pull it. Apparently not. Apparently you cannot pull wagons with this tractor. What a joke. Really nothing I'll use this tractor for if I can't pull wagons. It's cool, but I'm pretty sure I'll sell it. Now back to the little trick I learned in Farming Simulator 2012 was if you put this spreader on, put it on the front of this tractor, and you turn it on, and then you hire a worker, he'll fertilize the field for you. So that's always a positive note. Man, that thing does not hold much seed. I think this tractor might be able to pull trailer. Now, if we can get this tractor to pull trailer, we'll be in business. Put four-wheel drive. There we go. Alright, so we got our... Got a wagon all hitched up, ready to go. That's a big field. Oops. Wrong tractor. Now I added a new mod here. And this came straight from their website. So this is the new farming simulator map, you know, like I showed in the last video. Can't wait to get another combine so we can see how the new mod works. I would like to see how that works out. I know that a lot of American farmers will enjoy this new add-on. I mean, you can download more maps. I mean, there's lots of them out there. I had one that I downloaded, American farming map, and I love the map. It's just everything was, I guess, too glitchy, and they'd been working on the map and everything, trying to fix all the issues that everybody was having with it, and so I quit playing it. I haven't re-downloaded the newest release of it because it takes forever to download it. I still using the unregistered version of Bandcamp, so it ran out of time on there, like always. Now I'm gonna try this hireable worker thing here. If this tractor will pull this plow, which it looks like it will. Sorta. It's got the old school tricycle front end on it, that's pretty cool. How this works yet, but we'll give her a try and try to figure her out. Now I'm hoping that, I don't care if these two interfere with each other, it's just I hope he doesn't go over to the the land that's not been used yet, or you know, combined yet. We'll see how this works. If they'll miss each other or not. Oh yeah, that works beautifully. That didn't work out the way we wanted it to. ahead and get her tractor up out of the way here. While testing out new mods, you want to make sure that you don't screw up and take away some of your profitability there. It's looking awfully close. Yep. Alright. Back him up. I don't quite know how that's gonna work out. But so far, that mod works pretty good. I just gotta try and tinker with it and get it set the way I want it. I could expand that field. I don't know how much more I could expand it, but I can make it bigger. But I don't think we're gonna do that quite yet. Using this little combine. And we're set up for wheat right now, but we're gonna change that to barley. And here's the trick. You go back to your fertilizer spreader. All right, so you want to turn your fertilizer spreader on, and then hire your worker. Make sure you got the right seed. Let him go. He'll fertilize it as he goes. Yeah, it'll cost a little bit more because you waste a bunch of it, but it's just quicker. Whenever you get into a bigger field, you know, using bigger equipment. Maybe using bigger equipment to plant with, it just helps out so much more. But you gotta have the big equipment to plant with that plants the width of the fertilizer, and it just works out just perfect. We're gonna be saving up as much money as we possibly can, and first thing we're gonna buy is a silage cutter, and then we're gonna buy one of my downloads that I have on here, one of the mods, and that'll be to it's John Deere tractor, it's front end loader. Now what in the world is he doing this thing? I forgot to change that. Of course. This first video is just not, you know, it's testing. I'm testing out the new mods and everything. There's bound to be a few screw-ups. But if you ride along with this tractor, you can always... You can always come up and just turn the... turn the fertilizer off, and that'll save you some money. You just gotta keep an eye on it. I like the look, the plow leaves a lot more than the cultivator, but the plow's just not near as efficient. It takes a while to start actually making some real money on this game, but once you do, it seems to work out pretty good. Once you get some bigger combines, which I normally don't. I normally start immediately going to the biogas facility whenever I can afford the tractors and the equipment. just holding this guy up just for a second so he doesn't interfere with our combine. We're gonna let our planter make, I believe, two more passes, and then after those two passes, we'll turn on the fertilizer again. Get this tractor out of our way. So, this is where I'm gonna end this video, and when we come back, we'll still be on this field. So, like, subscribe, comment, and all that good stuff, and we will return. And I'll keep making some videos.